Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about sample size. When we collect sample data, we need to know how many sample units are needed. If we rearrange the formula for margin of error, we can get this formula for N, that is to know what the size of our sample should be, And that is the critical value ZA over 2 squared, and then P hat times Q hat over E squared. So if you're not given a p-hat in your problem, you assume it's 0.5. Because if we have 0.5, that value would give us the greatest possible answer for N. And it's better to err on the side of too many subjects in your study than having too few. So if you don't have p-hat, use 0.5. Okay, here we go. If we want to be 90% confident that the sample proportion has an error that is no more than 3 percentage points, how large would our sample need to be if we were given that p hat is 0.65? Okay, so we're going to just use that formula. First of all, 90% confident, that's a value that is found in an earlier video, but also 90, 95, and 99 are the most frequently used confidence levels. So if you get to know those values, you won't have to calculate that every time. 1.645 is the value I'm using for my Z over alpha over Z sub alpha over 2, because that's the number that's associated with the 90% confidence level. So that's going to be squared, and then p hat was 0.65 given in the problem. 1 minus p hat gives us q hat, which is 0.35. And then when they say 3 percentage points, that's 3% or 0.03 for our margin of error. That's an error that is no more than that. So 0.03 squared. And if you put that into your calculator, you get 648.023, which means we need at least 649 in our sample. So a few things about this. An error that is no more than 3 percentage points, that means our margin of error is 0.03. Critical value being 90% gives us that value. Our confidence level of 90% gives us the critical value of 1.645. That's an automatic thing, but go look it up if you need to see that again. And then Q hat is always 1 minus P hat. And the final answer always rounds up to the next higher number, because if we need just a little more than one person, we can't have a little bit of a person. So we always have to go up to make sure we have enough by going up to at least 649. That does not round up to 649 if you're just using the rules for rounding. But we have to remember, we have to have a right amount of people. 648 would be just a bit too little or too few. Okay, and then here's another example. How many adults use the internet? Using a confidence level of 95% and a margin of error of 4%, what should our sample size be? Notice in this problem that we are not given p hat. P hat was not given, so we assume that it's 0.5, which means Q hat is also going to be 0.5 because it's 1 minus 0.5. The critical value associated with the confidence level of 95% is 1.96. So 1.96 squared, P hat, Q hat, and then E squared. We were given the E was 4%, which is 0.04 squared. And so we would do that on the calculator and you get 600.25, which means we don't have 600 is not quite enough, so we need to round up to 601 in our sample. Remember, always go up to the next highest number. All right, have a fantastic day and we'll see you next time.